the best manipulation techniques. Learn how to influence people with NLP, mind control, dark psychology, and persuasion. Written by Michael Branson. Narrated by DMS. Introduction. The book explores the philosophy of manipulation by breaking down manipulation into its elements, developing meaningful, concrete concepts, and providing practical advice on how to influence others. The first section of the book deals mainly with the introduction and explanation of concepts that later form a basis for the specific parts of the book. It is important to know that much of the knowledge is general, because successful manipulation involves situational-specific actions. Rather than advising you what to do, this book will give you the ability to build successful persuasion techniques, whatever your interests and circumstances. In addition, the book covers all areas relevant to the development and implementation of effective manipulation strategies, including analysis, cold reading, and body language. The book does not describe deception as something inherently wrong, given its negative connotations. Ethical issues related to manipulation are dealt with in a dedicated chapter. We use and harass each other all the time in the real world. It almost seems that there's always someone waiting to take advantage of you at any turn. Within today's world, where the actual borders of the internet and various other inventions have been obliterated, you are at a much greater risk of being preyed on by other individuals. Not only are you preyed on by the people you interact with in the physical world, but there is also an additional threat to cyber predators. Simply put, humans have become even more predatory than wild animals. Most people would prefer to believe the best of all the people they meet until they have proven otherwise. Do you often think of them as a good person or a bad person when you meet a new person? Low chances are you want to believe that everyone has the same kind of heart as you do. They're never going to do anything to hurt you or anyone else. If you go through life believing that everyone is as good as you are, assuming you are indeed a good person, you are at a very high risk of being tricked or abused. When a human being is born, they are born with some inherent qualities that are critical to their survival. For example, an infant is born with the ability to weep in order to meet the needs of another human. This is because the baby just wants another adult to attend to them, because they're too little to do anything on their own. As such, an infant can weep when she feels to be fed, cry when she needs to sleep, cry when she needs comfort, cry for just about anything. Nobody taught this kid to cry. It's a survival tool that came right from the womb. If this child's parents do not impose clear limitations on how to respond to the child's needs, the child learns that it can do just about anything by screaming. Chapter 1. Understanding Manipulation and Manipulators. Manipulation is all around us, but you are not always able to see it. Because of this, you might compare it to many different common behaviors we are not always aware of. Manipulators act in form of creepy crawlies or vindictive insects, always lurking around that we don't know. You don't always feel it when they bite, but surely you will notice the wound well after the attack. Understanding the intricacies of body language. Just as you have turned to this book to boost your body language, so many companies and organizations have turned to behavioral scientists and psychologists to find out what makes people act the way they do and how body language operates. So let's attempt to use their results to some extent and start with a very easy query. What is body language? Body language is the way we interact with our bodies in a non-verbal manner. This definition may be inaccurate because, usually speaking, body language is not taken to include open hand gestures such as lifting a thumb or middle finger or using sign language. These types of body gestures are still verbal and direct in manner. Body language is usually taken as the subtle, unintentional, and indirect elements of interacting with our body. Even a thumbs up can be taken as sarcastic due to the correct grin. In reality, in the same sphere as body language, even some verbal communication is considered because how we say things is just as essential as what we do. Here, of course, there is a middle ground. Pointing your finger is a direct form of interaction, but it can also be involuntary, and finding out what our hands are doing is certainly essential to mastering the language of the body. Body language is reading our eye movements, posture, facial expressions, and how we move around to determine how to interpret what we say, and sometimes when we don't speak, to interpret what an individual might think or feel. It's okay not to be nervous at an interview in your speech, but if you're shaking like you're having an earthquake, individuals will know you're putting it on and nerves will show. The issue of whether body language is deliberate or unintended is a very hard question to answer. There are only a few rare occasions to ruminate and observe what's happening, not just in the discussion, but what's happening outside and around you. Reactions happen almost unconsciously, and you'll often find yourself saying, "That wasn't what I meant to say." And in those cases, you might begin to deconstruct your thoughts to figure out what you thought at the time. Our body language appears to have even less input from our minds than this, which has resulted in some talking about a conscious and subconscious opinion. This kind of division is helpful to many motivational speakers because it is drastic and simplistic. Your body seems to be acting on its own accord, revealing your hidden wishes. It would be some kind of hidden secret controlling it. The truth is that this division is generally flavored with Freudian psychology leftovers that are no longer taken with a lot of credibility. For simplicity's sake, it's best to think of the mind as getting the parts you're paying attention to at the moment, and next to that there's a lot of background data and procedures operating behind the scenes, but you can readily concentrate on them and change them at your own will. The way a computer works is ideal analogy. Usually, you'd run only a few programs at the moment. Some individuals would like you to believe that while you're distracted, your ancient emails and solitaire plot something against you. But that's not the case. Body language works as a component of your conscious awareness, as all you're doing at the moment does. But it also works on some instinctual levels and processes that we don't completely comprehend just yet. We often hear about how much our interaction depends on body language. Some statistics indicate that 55% of what we say is in the areas around our nose and eyes. One renowned figure suggests that only 7% of interaction is speech. While these numbers differ greatly from source to source, and it is not always evident what these percentages imply, even in real terms, it is sufficient to understand that a substantial quantity of daily communication is almost impossible without some sort of nonverbal interaction. Consider how we interact with text messages and internet chat systems, because so much of what we say can seem misleading or angry without a mouth or face behind it. It can almost seem necessary to use smiley faces and emotions. A simple question like, "Will you come to the dinner party?" without a friendly grin next to it, it can sound confrontational. Consider also how what we say is completely context-related. It's hard even to think of an expression that can be said outside a scenario. Take a straightforward sentence like, "Thank you." It could be viewed as dismissive, disingenuous, pleasant, or even accompanied by a hug or tears. It could be viewed as something highly...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.